The escorts of Dr. Richard Waldman, please accompany Dr. Waldman to the podium. Be seated. Fellows and guests, it is with great honor that I introduce you to Dr. Richard N. Waldman, the 61st President of the American Congress of Obstetricians and Gynecologists and the American College of Obstetricians and Gynecologists. Dr. Waldman, please repeat after me the following oath taken by your 60 predecessors. I, Richard N. Waldman, hereby swear.
I, Richard N. Waldman, hereby swear.
That I will do all in my power.
That I will do all in my power.
To uphold the bylaws.
To uphold the bylaws.
Of the American Congress of Obstetricians and Gynecologists.
The American Congress of Obstetricians and Gynecologists.
And the American College of Obstetricians and Gynecologists.
And the American College of Obstetricians and Gynecologists.
And that during the coming year.
And that during the coming year.
I will do.
I will do.
To the best of my ability.
To the best of my ability.
Faithfully lead and support.
Faithfully lead and support.
All educational, scientific, and advocacy activities.
All educational, scientific, and advocacy activities
of the Congress and the College
of the Congress and the College
and carry out all other duties of the President
and carry out all other duties of the President
justly,
justly,
fairly,
fairly,
and impartially,
and impartially.
To this I do solemnly pledge myself.
To this I do solemnly pledge myself.
Richard. Goodbye. Richard, I am honored to present you with this Medal of Office. Congratulations.
Jerry, on behalf of the College and the Congress, I would like to present you with this past President's Medallion. Thank you so very much, Jerry. You and Helen have had quite a year. Every OBGYN in this country should be grateful to you for all the time that you spent protecting patients in our specialty. I will always remember your strength and Helen's grace in a very trying year. Postpartum depression, your issue of the year, was very timely, and it's likely to have a lasting impact on our specialty. Last year, in your inaugural speech, you talked about standing on the shoulders of giants in our specialty, and you should know that to me, you're one of those giants. Thank you. I On this occasion, I'm mindful of the many people who gave me guidance and support on my journey. One such person right here on this stage is past President Richard Schwartz, who was a dear friend and a mentor. Last fall, my wife Elaine and I visited Richard in the intensive care unit months after his initial heart surgery. He had suffered one setback after another and was in good spirits despite the trach tube that prevented him from talking. After visiting him for a while, Dick grabbed a pencil and wrote down the two words, "I'm sorry." When Patty, his wife, Elaine, and I looked at him quizzically, he then completed the sentence, "I'm sorry because I've not been there for you in your president-elect year." Wow, you have to love this guy. Richard is one of the strongest and kindest men that I know, and this college is filled with people just like him. Thank you, Richard. Now let me introduce my escorts this morning. Pierre, will you please stand? Pierre Risk is an obstetrician and gynecologist from a prominent Lebanese family of physicians and nurses. He was the acting chair of the Department of OBGYN at the State University of New York Upstate Medical Center before he left for private practice. He then became chair at St. Joseph's Hospital in Syracuse. I could mention all of Pierre's awards, but I'd rather tell you about his enduring values. He is a remarkable teacher and mentor and a gifted surgeon, and he has an unquenchable thirst for quality and an overwhelming concern for the welfare of his patients. Pierre was the section chair in ACOG District 2 when he sent me to Washington to participate in the VRQC program. This was my first exposure to ACOG, and the rest is history. Pierre and I have shared coverage together, and later he became one of my partners. He is, in truth, my soul brother. He exemplifies the term Hakim, a word in Arabic that denotes a physician who is greatly respected and highly regarded because of his ethics and his ability. Mrs. Hakim, Ruth, his wife, flew in from Charleston. Pierre, thank you, and Ruth, thank you very much for being here today. Scott, could you please stand? Thank you. Scott Hayworth is the current chair of District 2. He's a practicing OBGYN, and he's also the president and CEO of the Mount Kisco Medical Group, an ever-growing multi-specialty group in Westchester, New York. In addition to his ACOG leadership posts, he is the former president of the Westchester OBGYN Society, and he will become chair of the board of directors of the American Medical Group Association, which represents 102,000 physicians and one-third of all the patients in the United States. There was a time when ACOG District 2 needed Scott to step up and show extraordinary strength of purpose, and he did it. Scott is an unsung hero to all of us in District 2. Scott's wife, Nan, could not be here today because she is running for Congress, and we wish her the best of luck. Thank you, Scott. Vicki, could you please stand? Thank you. Vicki Seltzer is the past president of ACOG and is a highly successful and highly respected oncologist. She is chair emeritus of the Department of Obstetrics and Gynecology of the Long Island Jewish Medical Center and North Shore University Hospital. Those of us who know Vicki recognize her as a tireless and dedicated advocate for women's health. Her optimism is infectious. She personifies the highest standards of excellence in our profession. And what many people don't know about Vicki is that she really works hard. She taught me early on that dreams don't come true unless you are motivated enough to work towards your goals and strive persistently until they are accomplished. Vicki demands perfection, and she was always at the top of her game. Richard is here today with you, Vicki. Thank you very much for being here. Elaine,